Hello, I'm Greg Hollows. Welcome to the Imaging Lab. In this segment, we're going to talk a little bit more about some unique types of illumination used for long linear objects. In the two cases that we are going to show here, one is more directional, one is more diffuse. As an example here, this linear array has an actual focusing lens on the front of it that allows us to get different widths of light or lines of light onto an object at a variety of distances. This can be very, very beneficial when we're trying to look at things, let's say it's like a web inspection application, we're looking at paper or material, fabric that's going by, and we want a long area of continuous illumination on one section of the object, because we might be using something like a line scan camera to actually analyze that full area, but it's only looking at one strip. So the directionality of the lighting doesn't actually hurt us as bad as what we saw with some of the directional lighting that we saw in one of the other segments, because we're getting a long, even illumination line. Now, the nice thing about illumination like this is that the lens sections that are here, these rods, can be changed out to get us a different line width different distances away. And really what we're trying to do is concentrate as much of the illumination as we can coming out of the LEDs or a fiber or whatever it may be into a small area so we get a large amount of light so we can make an object move very, very quickly and not have to worry about exposure times or the f-number setting of the lens as much and get very, very high efficiency through the system. So keeping uniformity is very, very critical on a light like this. We have a little bit more advanced one here. This unit is actually designed to give us a curved, diffuse illumination over an object. Now, in the segment that we looked at on domes, we were looking at things that were round, like a ball bearing, the bottom of a soda can, whatever else it may be. In scenarios like this, we might be looking at something like a pipe or some cabling or something like that, where we're trying to read code off of a surface to make sure that cable is the right length, size, color, whatever it might be, can handle a certain amount of power going through it. And we need to read off that information correctly to make sure it's going into the right bin or it's been built the right way or can be read by another operator the right way. This allows us to look at an object. Or we could take something that's highly reflective. Getting this nice diffuse area here that's on a curvature on something like a rod, like a something like a test tube or some other glassware, we could actually be able to rotate it through and get a diffuse area by looking through it with a camera on the back side. It gives us a very, very nice illumination profile. So for different objects, and when we think about them with different sorts of shapes or topographies to them, something that's a cylinder would work great with this. Something that's flat and is a web inspection application moving quickly, we would use something like this light here. And these are kind of specialized forms of both directional and diffuse illumination. Now, if you'd like to, you can click on any of the links to other illumination areas or to other imaging topics that you would like to look at.